So, hello everyone. Thank you so much for joining us, our artist to talk in this spring. We welcome our rising star ceramic artist Kodai Ujie and our dear friend and curator and writer Glenn Adamson tonight. So before we move on to the talk event, I'm going to go through a little guideline with you. So please set your view to gallery view to see the participants and mute your microphone during the event. And then turn your camera off, please. And if there are any questions or comments, please feel free to type them into the comment section. And this event will be from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. and followed by Q&A session. So feel free to turn your microphone and speak during the Q&A. We are looking forward to sharing with you. So we are very excited, especially this spring. After I came back from Japan, one of my highlights was visiting Kodai Ujie in Tohoku in Japan. So Kodai Ujie, he was born in Sendai City in Miyagi Prefecture in 1990. His father is actually an architect, and he built the studio and kiln space for him. Actually, it's very lovely. In 2013, he graduated from Tohoku University of Art and Design. And in 2015, he received MFA from the same university. He is currently working in Shibata-gun in Miyagi Prefecture, where there was a ground earthquake and tsunami in 2011. The Miyagi Prefecture is the northeast Japan, the sea side. And Kodai Ujie uses a unique technique of finishing work by adding colored lacquer to the crazed areas of the celadon pieces. He uses a combination of hand building through carving and pasting and wheel throwing for his works. Although the pieces are traditional blue celadon on porcelain, he occasionally uses concentrated cobalt oxide to create interesting compositions on the form. In his college time in 2013 to 15, he studied the traditional ancient ceramic history and the technique, and he was influenced by the old masterpieces. Since 2017 through 2019, he has been trying to search his original forms and creations in the table, in distracting the tradition, creating extraordinary shape with spread hip and dynamic lip. That was his form from his own passions for something imperfect. Why he is attracted to and taken with the imperfection? Why and how it is still table? Today, I'm sure Glenn and Kodai will bring these stories and talk about it. And currently, since last year, he's turning back to his understanding on tradition again. His new challenge is to deliver a new life to a concept of table. It is contemporary, yet should stand and swim in the current of Japanese chanoyu, way of tea. So he's waiting. And before, our dear friend and curator and writer, Glenn Adamson. Glenn Adamson is a curator and writer who works at the intersection of craft, design history, and contemporary art. He has previously been director of the Museum of Arts and Design in New York, head of research at the V&A in London. Adamson's publications include Fewer Better Things, Art in the Making, co-authored with Julia Bryan Wilson, The Invention of Craft, Postmodernism, Style and Subversion, The Craft Reader, Thinking Through Craft, and recently in January 2021, Craft, An American History was published. So since we got this pandemic started, he has been more committed and interact and engaging with artists and galleries, and his nonstop activities actually has been such inspiring and encouraging us in so many ways. So thank you, Glenn. So let's welcome our guests, Glenn and Kodai. Hi. Hi, Kodai. And how
are you? Oh.
Good morning. Ohayou
gozaimasu. Good morning.
It's early in the morning.
いやもう結構結構もう興奮して眠れなかったですね。
He said he was asleep because he was completely excited.
今日はよろしくお願いします。
Thank you so much for your time. So let's start. So Glenn, can't you take on?
Sure. And thank you for that kind introduction, Shoko. And and kodai ujie, ohayou gozaimasu.
Great. ohayou gozaimasu.
Hello, hello. I'm going to ask my questions in English. Shoko will translate. Also, as Shoko said, please put your questions in the chat as we go along, and we'll get back to them at the end. So it's such a wonderful honor to speak with you this evening or this morning, and I'm a great admirer of your work. It's such beautiful work that intersects with historical ceramics, but feels very contemporary. My first question is going to be about the Kizaimon Tea Bowl, which is an important source for you. I'm sure many viewers will know about this object. It was held up by Soetsu Yanagi and his colleagues in the Minge movement, particularly Bernard Leach and Shoji Hamada, as a kind of exemplar or key object showing the aesthetics of that movement and what they intended. I know that your interest has been very strong in this object since you saw the work in person and display at the Nezu Museum. And I wonder if we could start with this object and if I could ask what you see in it.
So, Kodai, Yanagi Soetsu の Minge という本は西洋にも訳されていて、その中で取り上げられている、まあ、井戸茶碗、キザイモンに関して、mm-hmm. ご自身が根津美術館で見た経験からどのような体験かをお知らせください。
Mm-hmm. はい。まあ、僕のその、まあ、茶碗を作るということでかなり大きな影響を与えた喜左衛門という茶碗は大きな存在なんですけれども、まあ、僕がその最初に喜左衛門と出会ったのが2014年 の, 東京根津美術館での井戸茶碗展という本当にその井戸茶碗の名碗と呼ばれる者たちがこう勢ぞろいしたその美術館での展示だったんですけれども、まあ、元からこう喜左衛門という存在はなんだろう、こう、アマツログとか見て、その存在は知ってたんですけれども、まあ、実際にその足を運んで、井戸茶碗展見たときに、一番最初に美術館の中に入ったときに、入り口のところに、こう、ドンと、喜左衛門があったんですね。で、その喜左衛門を見て、なんだこの衝撃だっていうの、最初にもうすごい、ショックを受けて、すごい存在感がある、みたいな。あ、これが、今までこう写真で見てた喜左衛門か、実物を見て、すごい衝撃を得たんですけれども、で、そこからこう、なんだろうな、その他の井戸茶碗、名碗と呼ばれる井戸茶碗たちをこう見て、でもやっぱりなんかこう、喜左衛門の最初の、見たこう印象が、強すぎて、これをずっと引きずったままこう展示を見てて、で、そこから、なんだろう、こう全部見終わったときに、この、喜左衛門の思いが忘れられないと思って、もう一回、こう、喜左衛門のところに戻ってみたんですね。で、こうぐるっと、こう、まじまじと、こう、観察してると、なんだろうみたいな、この喜左衛門のこの存在感ってなんだろうっていうふうに、こう、考えたときに、なんだろう。まあ、こんなこと言ったらちょっと怒られるかもしれないんですけども、こう、喜左衛門が、なんだろうな、こう、ろくろの軸、実際こうろくろを引いた時にこう軸がまっすぐになるはずなんですけれども、まあ、ちょうどこう写真をこう見ていただくとこう軸がこう傾いてるんですね。 で、この…
Everybody wants this. So let's actually start my translation. So when he first went to the Venice Museum, it was when he was only 20 years old. And that time he knew that this ball in the book, in an art textbook, and he has some knowledge on those, this actually particular Kizaemon, National Treasure of Japan. But when he actually encountered that piece in the entry area in the Nezu Museum, which was the exhibition entitled All Edo Table, Only Edo Table Show, and he was completely hooked and drawn by this particular bowl, because that was very distorted, and it's even this it's completely unskilled, not really perfect, but also somehow clumsy and distorted, and it's not even stands like equally. And so he was just shocked that why this unskilled table still has this power and energy that speaks to his soul. That was his first impression, and that really made him realize that the art can be not imperfect, can be not perfect. It can still be a loving piece. We cannot help loving in spite of this imperfection. So that was his experience. Mm-hmm. And then Kodai, would you like to continue? もっと続けたいでしょうか？
はい。はい。で、その機材門ですね、こう見たときに、僕の中の印象で思ったのが、なんだろう、かなりこの六郎の、軸っていうのがこう傾いて、いて、で、かなりその歪みもその激しく感じたんですね。で、もともと、なんだろう、こう、井戸茶碗っていうのが、もともとその、朝鮮半島、今の韓国のところですね。で、もともと雑器として、庶民の、その、使う生活、雑器として作られてたんですけど、それを、日本に持ち帰ったときに、それを至高の、茶碗として、こう、扱った、こう、価値の転換が起きたんですけれども、だからその、職人たちは、もともと日本の名碗を作ろうと思って、作ったわけではないですね。で、そうしてみたときに、なんでこんなに歪んでるんだろうみたいな、なんでこんな傾いてるんだろうっていうふうに思ったときに、もしかしてこの機材門の、作った職人って、実はこれ、他のこう名腕たちのこう形整った端正な形のものに比べて、ちょっと下手な人が作ったのかなみたいな、思って、で、
He realized that why this is so attractive. The first thing he thought was that probably as the Glenn picked the book, but that it's exactly about the unknown artist who made for rice bowl or even the vessels and dishes for daily use in Korea. So probably that was the reason why it has such a beauty. And that time he as an artist discovered a new aspect of a ceramic piece. That was his story.
で、で、なんだろう、こう、もしくはすごいなんかこう上手い人っていうのがこう雑に作ったのか。じゃないとその、まあ、生活雑器としてはもう、いかにもこう扱いにくい。でもそこに日本の価値観っていうのが、なんかそう日本に持ってきたときに、それが最高のものとしてこう扱われたということは、なんだろう、で、機材もっていうのもその日本の中でも最上位とされる、もう名腕としてされてるんですけれども、そう考えると、こう、綺麗な形とか、端正な形っていうのを、作ることが名腕ではない。なんか、その代わりなんだろうな、こう、下手でも、こう、魂を揺さぶる、そういったその、まあ、歪みであったりとか、その時の手の跡であったりとかっていう、その瞬間性っていうのが、あ、そうか、これが名腕なんだっていうのが自分で感じたんです。
So he again, he wants to emphasize again that, you don't have to make an excellent ball, but something it speaks to your soul. It can be probably not skillful or not perfect, but it can still a very lovable piece, which is for him an excellent bowl. So that was his discoverer. And then probably we want to go through for the next slides that the influence, because Kodai wants to probably share some influence from the old pieces.
まあ、だからこう、なんだろう、こう形を、その、まあ、その時見て感じたのは、あの、機材も見て、その感覚がこう、なんだろう、こう楽になれた。一個ちょっとこう、気持ちが、あの、ちょっと価値観が変わったというか、あの、今まではやっぱりその形をこう整えなきゃいけないとか、こう綺麗にこう、あの、作らなきゃいけないという感覚があったんだけれども、あの、まあ、そういうのじゃなくて、まあ、とにかくこう自分のなんかこう腹からこう出したい表現みたいな、なんだろう、こう、まあ、本当にこう自分が伝えたい、もうこう魂のなんかこう叫びみたいな、なんかそういうのをこう作品にこう出していったらいいんじゃないかなみたいなっていうのを、まあ、思ったきっかけになった茶碗ですね。
That was a discovery also as an artist that、it was a relief. And then、he understood that、he can pursue, of course, the top-class technique and also the excellency of the techniques. But also at the same time, the most important thing is that to create something out of your flesh, like from your physical body and from your soul. If that is the clay work is the result of something out of yourself, that can be an art. That was his...discovery and then relief, he said.
Yes, you know, I had learned from Shoko that you also have a personal relationship to the idea of imperfection. Mm-hmm. And this is, of course, an idea that we associate with Japanese aesthetic philosophy. It's very, very commonplace in discussion of historic ceramics. But you also have a very particular relationship to the idea of imperfection. Mm-hmm. And I wonder if you would be...okay to speak about that.
So, Kodai sensei, そのなぜその不完全なものに惹かれていくか、そういう完璧でないものに惹かれていくかっていう自分の何かその生い立ちの部分で何か共有できる話がありますかという。
まあ、やっぱりその不完全なものになんかこう、なんかこう端正な形よりも、そういうなんかこう欠けてるものとか不完全なものっていうのにこう惹かれるっていうの理由はあの、まあ、僕自身がその生まれた時にその耳を持たないでその生まれてきたあの耳がない状態で生まれてきたんですね。あの、まあ、ていうか、まあ、それが一番、
interest, I mean, why he was taken with imperfection or he's attracted by something not perfect is because probablywhen he was born as a child, he did not have a left-hand side ear. And so he realized himself that he's not perfect. So that was his foundation to see something.
Mm-hmm. まあ、で、そういう、あの、まあ、それがすごい、あの、まあ、幼少期からすごいコンプレックスだったし、あの、まあ、そういった、なんだろうな、あの、まあ、こういう、あのまあ、だから自分がそういう不完全なその体だからなんかやっぱりこう綺麗な形よりもちょっとこう欠けてるものであったりとかあのそういう不完全な存在っていうのに多分すごい魅力を感じるんだと思うんですよね。まあ、だからまあこういうなんか自分でも不完全な自分でもまあなんだろうなこうもうしっかりこうなんか生きてるんだよとかそういうまあところっていうのはやっぱりこう見せたいのかなっていうふうにやっぱ自分の作品では思います。
So for him, through his work with the clay, he wants to prove that even imperfect a body can create something beautiful, or he has been having that inferior complex for years, but he now he's overcoming from the difficulties on this inferior complex that he's now tuning into the positive way to create something beautiful out of imperfection. So it's a very, very important and interesting foundation to see his work, I believe.
Yeah, that is a very profound, it's a very profound motivation for making the artwork. And it occurs to me that there's also something there about being special out of the great, you know, generality of people or objects, because the magic thing about the Kazaimon is that it's a tea bowl, like, or a rice bowl, like all the other bowls, but it's special. And recognizing that something that's imperfect in you can also be what makes you special and unique, that seems like a very powerful message.
やはりそのあのグレンさんもこのまあ元々メシジャワンだった色ジャワンね、それを取り上げてそれを美しいものに昇華したと同じように氏家さんの作品もそういうあの方向性、たとえそれが完全でないものであったとしてもいくらでも美しいものになるっていう大きなメッセージをいただいたように思いますというお返事。
はい。
Let me ask another question. This is about a very serious topic, which is the 2011 earthquake, the Tohoku earthquake that Shoko mentioned in her introduction. I understand that you were very strongly affected by this disaster, and that it actually, in a way, had a positive effect on you, if I can put it that way, because it had an influence on your decision to focus on clay and artistic creativity. And I wonder if you could describe the impact of this event that happened 10 years ago.
それではその10年前に11年に東北大震災があったと、そのことがどのように政策あるいは人生においてあの契機となっているのかということですね。
まあもともとはやっぱり、まあのまあ、その陶芸をこう始めたっていうきっかけが、まあもともとは何だろうな、そのまあ、その大学、美術大学にこうあの入って、あのまあ、こうちょっとこう楽しそうだからとか、あのちょっとこう興味があったことをその大学で学びたいなと、ちょっとこう軽い気持ちだったんですけど、まあ、まだそれあの本当にプロ の, その芸術家になろうとは思ってなくて、であのまあ、その時矢先ですね、僕が大学2年生の終わりの頃に、あのそういう、東北大震災っていうのが起きて、でまあ、それがあの実家の仙台の方で、あの被災したんですけれども、あの、まあ、本当にそれが人生観変わる出来事で、まあ、本当に死ぬ思いをしたし、あのやっぱり大変だったし、あのでこう目の前のくてこう火事とかもこうあの、まあ、起きてたりして、まあ、それを見ながら、なんだろうな、まあ、本当に人っていつ死んでもなんかいい準備をしとかないといけないんだなとか、あの、まあ、いつ死んでもまあ後悔のないようにまあこれから生きようっていうふうにも覚悟する。
So it was when he was only 20 years old that he really experienced this tremendous disaster, and then many hometowns were swallowed, and then he also saw many, many fires after the water devastated. So at that time, he thought that he must get ready to die whenever, and let he wants to live, not to make any regret in every second. And at that time, the ceramic art was just the object when which himself could try hard and try best. He did not have any plan to be artist, or he did not have any determination about the ceramics. But at that time, he studied just clay work.And then that happened, and that made him take, this is what I will do my best. So this was just an object. It could be different medium, but the moment was, for him, clay was there. Interesting, isn't it?
Yeah.
で、そうですね。まあ、で、その時、あの、まあ、とにかく、こう、あの、なんだろうな、あの、もう自分がこう目の前になんかこう頑張れる、ことっていうのがすごいあの必要だったんですね。あのまああのまあ、とにかくこう自分がこうあの捧げられるものっていうのは何だろうってやっぱり考えた時に、やっぱその時に目の前にその大学で入った陶芸っていうのがあって、まあ、とにかくまあこれを、もう必死にこう頑張るんだっていうふうに思った、きっかけで、でまあ、その時はあのまだそのプロの芸術家になるとは思っていなかったんですけれども、まあ、それが、まあ、勉強していくうちにまあそういう、まあ、茶の湯とかでもそうだし、そういったあのアートの世界であったりとか、そういう深さっていうのを知れて、まあ、これを何だろうな、僕の人生でこれなんかこうかけて、やってみたいなっていうふうに思って、そういうプロの芸術家っていうのをこう目指したいなっていうふうに思った。まあ、やっぱり大事ですよね。
Yes, at that time he was not、 meaning to be a professional artist, but he needed some reason to live. He needed to have something motivating him, and he wants to devote himself towards something he wants to be passionate. So that was a clay, and then at that time, he also encountered the world of Chanoyu, the way of tea in Japan. And that was profound in his life and art. And so it married together, and they married together, and then now he's making the new tea bowl every day. So the 10 years ago, the natural disaster made him, I think, artist.
Yeah. Very. It's a great topic to be talking about now in the wake of the disaster we've had in the past year and the tragedy of the COVID epidemic. Mm-hmm. And I think this idea that you should not leave anything unfinished because you never know what will happen, that's very powerful. So every tea bowl might be your last, it's a strange thing to say, but it has to have that idea and that sense of commitment to every object that you make. That's a really powerful artistic idea. Mm-hmm.
そのグレンさんはやはりその今の時代もねこうやってコロナがあってやはりその天才とはまた違う形の悲劇が起こっているそういう中で あなたが作っているそのメッセージっていうのは今こそ大事な要素だし結局終わってない仕事をするしてもね死ぬわけにいかないということでそのやっぱり生きるコミットメントをその持って臨みたいっていうまあ大きなメッセージを持ってるんでしょうねっていう
ありがとうございます、やっぱりその逆境である、僕もその耳がない状態であったりとか大震災とか言ってやっぱりその逆境こうそれに対してもがいてもがいた先にその自分のそういう何だろうなこう新しい価値観強烈な価値観っていうのをこう生み出せるんじゃないかなっていうふうには思っています。
So he, as Glenn told us, he also agrees and believesthat the disaster or the pinch is a chance. And then always the innovation is coming from the very difficult times. So he also agrees with Glenn's idea, especially in the current state of the world.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, speaking of innovation, I think we should now turn our attention to the actual ceramics, mm-hmm. because they're very special. They're very beautiful, but they also have some special features that we can talk about. And what I particularly wanted to ask you about was the way that you use colored lacquer to articulate the surface, really almost like a painter. And as Shoko said, you also sometimes use cobalt to enrich the surface. And I'm sure this is a very knowledgeable audience, so people will understand the difference. But the more, flowing dark blue is the cobalt. And then these other colors that are very unusual in the context of ceramics are lacquer that's worked into the cracks of the glaze after the firing, of course. And of course, this also might remind this knowledgeable audience of kintsugi, the practice of gold repair. So I wanted to ask you about the origin of this idea of the lacquer coloring and your thoughts about it as an artistic technique, what it allows you to do.
So, その作品に関してじゃあ話をしたいんですけど、特にやっぱりまず驚くのがこの色使いだったりとか、この釉薬のまあユニークな点。こういうその制作技法に至ったそのまあなのか、あるいは方向性なのか、その辺を聞かせくださいと。
はい、これは説明でもあったと思うんですけど、その僕はその、陶器のその貫入に対してその漆を染み込ませる技法ですね、オリジナル技法を使ってこういったその表現に至ってるんですけれども、よく炭を使ってこう貫入を染める方法っていうのは日本でもよくメジャーな技法としてあるんですね。でもこのオリジナルでこういう漆を使うっていうのは僕がオリジナルでこう使ってる技法であって、で、それがなんでこういうふうにこうできたのかっていうと説明をすると、これが2013年の壺ですね、丸壺があって、
So let's see the white tea, I'm sorry, white jar the very first jar that he created in 2013. Let's see here. Yes, this is the very first piece that he created using this.
でこの丸壺が僕のその漆を使ったその作品で初めての作品なんですけれども、これが大学の4年生の卒業制作の時に作ったもので、これが最初漆を使う予定はなくて、最初こう真っさらな青白磁のその壺を卒業制作で提出するつもりでいたんですね。でちょうどこう卒業制作のこう提出の前日になって、もう窯からこう出した時に、まあこうピキピキっていう風に青白磁の貫入が一本一本こうカンカンっていう音しながらこう音が入ってくるんですけれども、その時に何だろうな、こうカンパンって入ってるな、こうビキっていう風になんかちょっとこう鈍い音がして、これなんだろうと思って見たら、ちょうどこの口元のところに、まあこれちょっと壺の後ろの方なんですけれども、ミューといってその口元のひびっていうのはこう貫入ができる過程で素地自体にこうひびが入っちゃったんですね。
So it was back then for in his graduate thesis piece in 2013. He was ready to submit this most making effort piece to the graduation, and that was quite.Porcelain jar. He was inspired by Joseon white porcelain in Korea, and that was the shape two bowls together, joined two different parts together. He joined like this. This was his idea to create that. But the day he pulled out from the kiln, after it get cooled down and dry, and it has a sound.That he listened, that little the sound of the crack, and he was so scared. And even he heard the sound of a dull sound, like very big sound. And at that time, it was devastating for him. So でどうですか、その次の。
で、まあ、どうしようかなみたいな、その次の日、まあ、卒業制作の展出になるし、この絵じゃ作品出せないなっていうふうに思って、もうどうしようかなってこう考えてたら、あ、そうだ、このひびのところを漆で継いで、まあ、補修したらいいんだっていうふうに最初思ったときに、あれ、これって、この赤の漆っていうのを、この貫入に染めれば、このひびに入ったところっていうのをこう目立たなくすることができるんじゃないかなと思って、で、こうどんどんこう漆やっていくと、あ、貫入にどんどんこう、ひびのところに漆が染み込んでいく、あ、これ面白いなと思って、こう全体にやったら、まあ、こういったようなこう表情が出てきたんですね。まあ、これがすごいな、うん。
Yeah, next,、まあ、he actually decided to make something out of it, out of this fault. He decided to actually use the technique he learned. It was actually lacquerware he studied when he was a college student. So he decided to use red as a color and start absorbing in those clays in part. And that actually became his result. That was a surprise and he never planned.
Mm. Mm. I love the story of the sound.The ceramic as the cracking is happening.
音の話がいいですね。そのびっくりした時の音の。
It's like, yes. like you've translated the sound into color, which is a beautiful idea.
Yeah, the 音をね、訳すの難しいねって言われた。日本は、yeah, 日本 in Japanese we use those sound like, you know, I have a headache like a.頭がガンガン痛い or
ああそうなんだ。
I am so hungry. My stomach is making a sound goo or we use a lot of sound in Japanese language.
That's nice.
Yeah, that's a very funny story.
But it reminds you that a ceramic, a fired ceramic, is not just an object; it's also an event, and it's an event that's captured physically, and it's a way of highlighting that.Quality of time that the object happened at this moment, and it's like you're drawing attention to that.
Mm-hmm. Glenn, you had a wonderful statement. So I'm going to translate to Kodai. So, 焼き物っていうのは、その結果というだけでなく、やっぱりそのイベント、その起きてしまうこと。
うん、
特にスピーダーに。That's very beautiful. I love that.
So let me ask another question. This actually follows in a way.Because there's also the event that happens later for ceramic, particularly in Chanoyu, you have a kind of ritual atmosphere in which the bowl, for example, may be used. But of course, your work may just go into a museum or a gallery or a collector's home and be admired without being used in that way. I wonder what you think about that and whether you think that your workrequires something different when it's used as opposed to when it's only looked at.
そしたらその質問としては結局その自分のその焼き物の立ち位置とか、その日本で特にどうやってその自分の茶碗作家としてなのか、あるいは陶芸家としてなのか、日本におけるその陶芸の潮流だとか。その辺の中での自分の今の現代に来ている中の立ち位置について聞きたいということですね。
そうですね。まあ、僕自身、まあ、立ち位置の話をすると、なんだろう、まあ、日本でこう茶碗というものをこう作ってて、こう感じることっていうのは、そのやっぱりこう、まあ、アートとその茶の湯のやっぱりその壁をやっぱり感じてしまうんですね。っていうのは、そのまあ、茶碗 の, その知識がない人っていうのですか、その僕 の, その作品を見たときに、まあ、その人が言うにはなんかこう自分はこう茶碗の見方がわからないからって言って、なんか僕の作品を見たときにその作品を見て感じたままにこう受け取ってもらえない、
so,
でなんかこっち、
Especially in Japan because we have this historical tradition and tea, their cultures.It's a challenging actually that so many people have like a preconception about tea bowl or prejudice about tea bowl. Tea bowl should be like this. Tea bowl should be like this. So there is some kind of a background of our understanding on the tea bowl. So some people has this difficulties and then sometimes it's inaccessible to his cutting edge tea bowlSo he recognized this, there is a wall between art and tea bowl. He can be a contemporary artist, like a fine art sculptor, or he still makes tea bowl. That was his challenge. And so it's his question at the same time in being in Japanese artist in Japan.
Yeah. You know, I was going to ask you also about the quality of your generation as a kind of moment in ceramic history. And I was thinking about the artist Takuro Kawata, who actually has a show on with our colleagues at Salon 94 right now in New York City, in their new building, which you should all see. So you were born in 1990. Kawata-san was born in 1981.I was born in 1972, so I'm very old, but, yeah. But so there's actually a decade between you and Kawata, but it seems to me that not him alone, but there was a kind of generational break there that seemed to me to introduce other qualities into Japanese ceramics, a kind of pop sensibility maybe, also a kind of violence and extremeness in...what had been, certainly a fascinating and varied field. And we also have people like, Kazuo Yagi and the Sodesha ceramic. So it's a complicated history, I know, but it does seem to me that Kawata introduced a very new energy into the field. And I wonder whether you think of yourself as fitting into a moment in Japanese ceramic history, maybe together with people like Kawata, and more generally how you would describe what you see your peers making now and how you would describe the current moment in Japanese ceramics.
そうすると、その、まあ、今、あの、宇治江先生は1990 90年生まれで、そして、桑田拓郎は、1990年生まれで、自分は1970年生まれで、それぞれ10年ぐらい年が離れている中で、結局ジジエ先生が一番若い世代、10年10年10年とこうなってきて、うんうん、そういう中でその、まあ、彼の政策が及ぼしたまあ影響だとか、あるいはその、まあ、若い世代の中で自分のその、ポジショニングというか、どういうふうに捉えてますか、うん、っていうことなんですよね。うん
うん、まあやっぱりその、まあ、さっきの茶碗の話で、なんだろうな、こう茶碗っていうだけでこう専門的にこう見てもらえないっていうのが、ね、やっぱりそういうなんか先入観を感じてて、でその先入観っていうのをこう取り払ったっていうのが、こう僕は桑田さんだと思っていて、で、まあ、桑田さん当時あのそういうあの、まあ、10年前にあの工芸未来派で、そういう金沢ですごいこう有名な展示をされて、あの、まあ、その時にその茶碗の表現っていうのを、あの、まあ、かいらぎという技法、まあ、茶人がこう好むあのそういうあの技法をあの肥大化させて、あの、まあ、すごい極端にこう肥大化させて、それがこうあの茶碗以外、あの茶碗を知らない人でも、なんだろう、こう、あの、なんだろう、こうすごい強いインパクトがある、あの、まあ、茶碗の表現をしながらも、こう茶碗の評価を超えたというふうに僕は考えていて、あの、
That what he Kuwata did significant was that to he got rid of the somebody's prejudice on the tables. So he actually made the table's world expanding, but also he created something beyond the table. So what he did was significant.And then when he saw the pieces in the Kanazawa, actually 21st Century Museum, which Glenn also worked for the Kōgei Future Forward show in New York, that time Kōdai saw Kuwata's tables, he realized that he really enlarged the world of table, and he got beyond the world of table.And that was a shocking moment.
Mm-hmm. It's fascinating, isn't it, that you know, the same object could be both inside the category and outside it. It's almost like a poem. Like a poem is about a river or a moon or a forest, but it's also something totally different from that, something abstract. Mm-hmm. So it's like the same object has these two faces, we could say.You recognize it as a tea bowl, but you also recognize it as a vivid sculpture, and the two things interact in a very energetic way.
その茶碗であるということは、やっぱりその内なる世界と外が見えている世界って、この2つの世界が合わさったものっていうところは、やっぱり茶碗の同じ彫刻でもそういうのはない。やっぱり外の世界と内の世界があるっていう、このやっぱ面白さっていうのは、あの、たとえそれが機能的に使えない茶碗だったとしても、やっぱり茶碗の面白さかもしれないなっていう印象を今おっしゃって
ます。まあ、なんだろう、その僕自身はその茶碗っていうことは、なんだろうな、なんか一種のこうあの映画のようにこう感じていて、あの映画のキャスティングですね、でその茶道具っていうのがその、まあ、映画でいう俳優で、亭主が、プロデューサー、でもちろんその映画の成功にはそういうプロデューサー の力ももちろん必要だし、まあ、千利休、あの日本の茶人とかは、まあ、そういう名もないその道具たちをこう有名なあの道具にあの仕立て上げた、まあ、本当に名プロデューサーとしてなんか思うんですけれども、だからまあ要はそういうなんか素人のみの映画でコテコテ俳優ばっかりの映画、まあ、あの、まあ、それはどっちがいい悪いとかではなくて、まあ、最終的には映画の完成度とかっていうのがこう問われてくると思うんだけれども、で僕はそれに対して、うん、個性的なこう範囲を作る、そんな感覚なんですけど、
個性、うん、So he actually tried to think like a chanoyu, the tea way of tea as a culture. He thinks that a chanoyu is kind of a movie. The host is a producer. Host can be a director of the movie, and he is casting.Tea wares like tea bowls, tea caddy, water jar, incense burner. Those tea utensils are like a casting for the movie. So he is trying to enjoy, to create some colorful character, a unique kind of a character, not necessarily the main star or I don't know, but he said that the colorful character can be a very charismatic part in the tea ceremony, which is a stage, which is a movie. So he think like this way in a modern context.
That's great. Mm-hmm. I think your tea bowl should win Oscar for best supporting actor.
この茶碗はオスカーの映画のオスカーの賞を取るべきでしょうね。
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I see we only have a little more than 10 minutes left. So I just wanted to remind people that if they have questions, they should put the questions in the chat and we will, of course, we'll try to answer them.
So で、その今から質問のセッションに入る前に、どうでしょう、宇治先生から逆に茶碗、どの茶碗を作りたいだとか、あるいはグレーに対する質問だとかありませんか？
そうですね、まあ、僕自身は、まあ、先ほど言ってみる、まあ、要はこう茶碗の中での何だろうな、最終的にはその茶碗でありながらもそういうグローバルなその茶碗っていうのをこう外に向けたその茶碗っていうのを作りたいというふうに考えてるんですね。で、で世界では何だろう、そういうアートとクラフトっていう関係、まあ、なかなかその日本の中にその情報が入ってこないんですけれども、一体こうどういうことがこう世界の中でアートクラフトの関係っていうのがこう起きているのか、でその中で何だろう、こうグレンさんがその僕の作品に対してこう何だろうな、こうどうこう可能性をこう見て、いただけるのかっていうのをお聞きしたいな
と。Okay, Kodai has a question to Glenn. He is making tea bowls and he's trying to create something universal or something global out of his traditional study from Japanese teawares. So his question is that how do you perceive between art and tea bowl, art and those crafts? Between those works, if you can share with us your thoughts on that.
Yeah, I'll try to be brief. just a few words. Well, like many other people in the West, I think the Japanese regard for ceramics as a viable art form is very inspiring. So the way that ceramics is treated in Japan is like we would treat painting and sculpture here. So that really expands the view of what a tea bowl can be, of course. Maybe Shoko, do you want to translate that much? And then I'll say a bit more.
To be honest with you, I'm going to have a long translation after this session. So don't worry. Let's
okay.
talk and then our audiences are in New York. So yes.
Okay, cool. So the other thing I would say is that instead of thinking of art as an inherent quality, I think it might be more interesting to think of it as a way of looking at things. So, in a way, it doesn't matter whether it's ceramics or paint on canvas or bronze that you think of as art. The main thing is that you look at things and make things with that intention. So it's not built into the materials, and it's not a certain genre. It's really about a kind of value and expectation that you bring to the object. And then, of course, you can build so much with that. And we see how much beauty and poetry and insight is created around ceramics, not only through Chanayu, that's a great example, but through many other ways of thinking about ceramics as well. And I think the Japanese have really taught the whole world how to see that, just as other cultures would teach us to see the beauty in textiles or in certain kinds of architecture. It's a really special thing to Japanese culture. And I think, not only Japanese artists, but artists all around the world benefit from that lesson that historic ceramics hold.
So, Kodai, translation はあのこの後にしますっていうのが時間が、あの、それからすごくいい、素晴らしいメッセージが、あの、フィロソフィーがあるので、またこれはゆっくり訳しますのでね。で、あの、So, thank you, Glenn. That is a very powerful message. And then your understanding is always inspiring. And I feel like we are so privileged to share this moment through our artists and through our beautiful works. And so how about we can go with Q&A session?We have 7 more minutes. How do you think? And do you pick some questions?
Sure. We have some great questions already from some great people. So first, Halsey and Alice North just have a technical question about how the lacquer is put in the cracks. So could you please describe the process of that?
So, ノースさんからの質問なんですけれども、この、はい、自分にとってその作品を作る上で何かこう大事なことなのかと、その作品に対するその思いですよね。そういうものをちょっと聞きたいと。うん、
そうですね。まあ、作品に対しては表現に関しては、まあ、こういった漆のそういう技法を使ってるんですけれども、まあ、僕やっぱりそれでこの イメージのそのソースっていうのがやっぱりちょっとこう細胞的であったりとか生物的なちょっとこう有機体のようなイメージがあるんですけれども、まあ、本当にこう生きているような感じに動き出しそうな感じに見えるっていうのが何だろうな、よりその生命的細胞的に見えるようにするように心がけてますっていうのは、やっぱり僕自身がやっぱりこういう何だろうな、こういう耳の関係だったりとかして、そういう遺伝であったりとか細胞で切り出であったりとかっていうのをすごいこう意識する存在なのかなと思います。
Since he was a child, as he already shared a little bit, he was born as a new year, and so he's always aware about genetic inheritance. Actually, he recently have his own little baby, the daughter.She's so cute, and she has all fine, and whole body is safe and sound. And so he was so happy and then amazed by the nature. But what he wants to talk with you is that his work can be very organic form, and his evidence of throwing can be a shape of the flesh or the even the lines of the.Crazes are capillary or the vessels of the blood, or his work can be very cell and biotic. So that probably is his main concern and main motivation, that he creates something like very organic form.
I like that. That's a very metaphorical answer rather than a technical one.Which is kind of nice. John Carpenter, the great curator from the Metropolitan, has a question also about the cracks and asks, is this an effect that took a lot of time and experimentation, or was it more natural? So is it something that has to be cultivated carefully over time, the cracking effect?
この貫入の中にこの色を入れていくっていう、まあ、技術的な話なんですけど、その面に関して、すごくそれは時間を要するというか、いろんな実験やいろんなことを重ねてできていくものなのか、あるいは割とスピーディーにできて、どういうその、まあ、技術的な背景がありますか、ここの貫入に色を入れるということに関して。
技術的な背景、まあ、ちょっとこう技術に関して、まあ、どういうふうにこう漆を入れるかっていうのも、よく聞かれるんですけれども、まあ、ちょっとこう、なんていうかな、こうちょっと企業秘密的なところもあるんだけれども、まあそうですね、まあ結構そういう、なんだろうな、まあ漆を入れる、まあこれだとこの あの赤い漆を入れて、ここの部分にちょっとこうピンポイントこう緑の漆を入れてるんですけれども、まあ、そういうその色の、そういうなんかその操作はあのできますね。まあ、これとかだと、そういうあの、まあ、赤の漆であったりとか、この青の漆で入れたりとか、まあ、かなり結構あの、色漆っていう、あの結構日本ではそういうあのカラー の, あの漆っていうのがあのこういっぱいあるので、でそういうところでこういう、なんだろう、まあ、赤とか青、緑以外にもいろいろ紫であったりとか、あのそういうあのなんだオレンジ色であったりとか、結構カラフルなあの漆があるので、そういう意味では、あのそういう表現がこう、カラーのバリエーションがこうあの増えるのかなというふうには思います。
Mm-hmm. So that first, jar that he finished in 2013 was almost like accidentally, he discovered and then invented the technique like by accident.But since then, he has been working hard to create how it can be his technique. So what he's currently doing is that to choose the right color lacquer. In Japan, there are some colored lacquers. So that was his luck, he said. But at the same time, it's a very gamble that it works or sometimes it fails. So again, this still is aExperimental, but at the same time, he's still making effort. That's what he's trying to say. Mm-hmm.
I noticed we have another question about how well the bowls age with use, whether the lacquer means that they're actually not functional. Could you ask?
お茶碗に関してなんですけども、これを使っていく中で、あの、変化していく、経年変化していくと思いますか？あるいは注意しなければいけないことはとりわけありますかって、この貫入があることで。
まあそうですね、まあ、貫入、まあ、よくね、そういう経年変化ってあのこう育っていくあのっていうのを、まあ、日本 の, あの茶の湯ではこうあの良しというふうにあのされていくんですけれども、あの、まあ、そういう意味では僕自身は結構こう貫入最初からこう漆を入れてるので、まあ、そういう意味でちょっとこう時間をこう操作してるのかなみたいなって自分で思ったりもするんですけれども、まああの注意点としては、まあ、これが漆っていうのをこうあの、まあ、ちょっと特殊な形であの作品に入れてるので、あのやっぱりまあちょっと保管としてはやっぱりそういうのを直射日光を避けたりとかあのっていう、まあ、ちょっと本当に漆の作品としてこう扱うっていうところがまあ必要になってくるのかなっていうのを思いますね。
So as for the aged deterioration, he already controlled to create the artificialclays and then makes it into lacquer. So it does not, you don't have to really care about the future clays because he already covered with that lacquer. But again, he appreciates over time the ceramic get some kind of colors of the stains or something. It's just totally fine and he wants to see.After somebody uses the bowl.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just to bring it back, here we are at the end, but to bring it back to the beginning, the Kizaimon tea bowl now looks very different from when it was first made, I'm sure. Mm-hmm. And it's even more beautiful. So we can look forward to the same thing happening with Kodai Sensei's work.
Kizaimon のね、茶碗だって当時生まれたばかりの時は全く違ったでしょうから、時間をかけて、こう変わってきた美しさがあって、私たちがそれを目にしてるから。That's so true.
Yeah.
So I think we are running out of the time, but first of all, it's been so enjoyable that you first met from Tohoku to New York and through wonderful art, we could share so many things.And that proves that art is wonderful. And so, Glenn, thank you so much. And Kodai, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. And in June, we will have a wonderful exhibition only featuring contemporary tea bowls in June. And Ujie is certainly our.Star artist. So please stay tuned and then see you soon. Thank you so much.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.